Did you hear the big, look at Hector. Did you hear the big news?
I have big news.
Okay, what's the big news?
Canelo signed 11 fight deal with DAZN.
11 fight deal?
11 fight deal with DAZN.
The boys with DAZN now?
Golden boys, 11 fight deal
with DAZN. What does that say? Eddie Hearn, give Eddie Hearn a shout out, he did it.
Eddie Hearn, you don't even know. I was talking to Eddie Hearn right now.
Oh.
Love it.
Hey.
Did you tell him about B-Fly?
Yeah.
I got it, Elie.
You have a white kid too.
Huh?
Stop hustling.
You have a lot of Mexicans and one white guy.
Elie, I got so much shit going on and you fucking bring up beef lane.
I just like, you call me
right now? Just fucking around. I like to fuck with this kid. I like fucking with this kid.
We're just joking. So what happened? 11 fight deal. That's huge. Yeah, that's that is huge. Huge.
That's awesome. Good for Golden Boy. All of our guys.
He has Anthony Joshua.
You guys are good now. We were a little worried.
With her.
We were a little worried. Let's just be real. We were a little worried about Golden Boy, but now we're good.
So what does that say for Eddie to get Canelo for 11 fights?
That's what he just told me. He just told me and said, look, that makes a big difference. All these other guys that don't believe in me, now
they don't have a choice.
They don't have a choice.
He's the biggest UK star and the biggest United States. Yeah.
Wow. Did he tell you how much he's paying Canelo?
Doesn't matter a lot.
He's making a lot of money, Eli.
He's making Canelo. Everybody's making
Canelo's
money.
Making a lot of money.
So do you
get money. You get money. We all get money.
No, what is that? You're okay.
We have two on Canelo's undercard.
Two? Who else?
Eh?
Who else?
I'll let you know.
So Canelo's on DAZN. What does that mean for DAZN right now? What do you mean?
That's the
DAZN
biggest,
without Canelo.
Like Pete, I just said, the biggest fucking boxer.
The three biggest: Canelo, Anthony Joshua, and Ryan Garcia. They got Ryan Garcia now too.
Yeah, but that's not the biggest. Come on, man.
He's got a million followers on Instagram.
But Canelo has a pay-per-view draw, and Joshua brings 90,000.
Yeah,
and Ryan Garcia brings a million little girls.
And then, but. Maybe their fight's gonna.
Like a million little girls.
We ain't starting yet.
A bunch of little schools.
Next year, you guys will be fighting in the zone too. That's good. I'm really.
So how did Eddie do this move?
I'm really excited.
Robert, how is Eddie able to make this move? Is it because HBO folded and they had the opportunity?
He took advantage of it. He's got the fucking money.
He made them
a fucking good ass offer. He made them a good ass offer that they couldn't really refuse.
But he did it on his own. People didn't believe in him.
I believe in Eddie Hearn now. That's good shit.
Hearn.
With that,
I've been telling my dad about Eddie Hearn.
Do you think that will mean that Mikey might fight one day in the zone or Eddie?
No, it's not.
Let's not talk about that.
Okay. How about B-Fly? You think he can fight in the zone?
I could probably get him there.
So no more Arizona for you? Would you be depressed?
Huh?
If you don't fight in Arizona?
There's an AZ in the zone. DAZN. AZ Arizona. Marketing genius right there.
You know, you watched a scary movie once and he had a nightmare that till now chases him?
No, it doesn't chase me. I'm explaining. All right.
We're talking about serious boxing.
Yeah, we're talking about serious. Come on.
No, Robert.
It's Friday. Go watch Halloween.
Tell Robert about your nightmare.
Oh, Friday. I'm going to watch
Halloween. All right, so one time when I was a little kid, I was like.
Es la viejita, pero la remake.
Robert, you got to hear about it. You got to hear about his nightmare.
You don't have to hear it if you don't want to.
Are you going to cry?
No.
Did you cry?
No.
Tell him the story.
You're getting choked right now. I can tell. This is your own.
All right, listen.
First of all, have you had glazed pizza, LeBron's thing?
Yeah, it's pretty good. Glazed pizza's pretty good.
Okay, what happened?
All right, so I had a nightmare. I was getting chased by this guy with an axe. But he cut off my leg. I was in the shed, he ended up catching me, cutting off my leg off. And you're waking up, I couldn't feel my leg. Trippy, right? Tell me why.
Because you were having, it was one of those dreams where you get paralyzed. Pita, what's those dreams called?
Huh?
Oh, te paralizas?
Oh, those are badass.
Yeah.
¿Cómo sleep paralysis.
Sleep paralysis. Yeah.
Le pasó el pie.
Where
you got stuck?
Well, I got my leg cut.
Se durmió en el pie.
Then that's not
what. Yeah,
no, se durmió en el pie.
His leg got cut off. So when he woke up, he was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, because it was
sleep paralysis when your whole eyes shut down, but your eyes are open.
Yeah.
The first time it happened to me, I thought I was dying. I was like 13 years old. I had never heard of it. And I was in bed. I was sleeping down.
No, it's scary. No, it's happened to me a couple times.
It's happened. Watch.
It's happened
10 times now. But the first time, I was like 13 years old, and I'm like trying to fall asleep and whatever. And I remember that I was watching TV or something. I was like little by little falling asleep, and boom, I'm out, but my eyes stay open. So my whole body is I can't move. I can't scream. I can't do anything. I'm just stuck there with my eyes open. I thought I was dying. I was like, what the fuck is going on? I can't move.
What, sleep paralysis? That shit happens then, all the time.
And then I woke up and I was like, what the fuck? I got
Why
scared.
Does that happen? What's
I
the cause?
I ran upstairs. My dad wasn't there. I woke up my mom and I told her, like, what the fuck? You know,
what's
was
the cause
scared.
Of it?
How old are you? Sleep paralysis. I was like 12, 13, 12? Something like that. And then now it's happened to me a lot, and I actually like it. It's pretty cool. Like, I'm just like, like I'm trying to move.
But Robert, what's the reason for
it? It's happened to me a few times where I'm trying to scream, like, to scream it out, and you just can't. You just can't scream. You just
happens to me all the time now.
And then it goes away, and then you're
in the middle of the day, like, in the middle of the day, I'll be tired. I want to take a nap. I try to go to sleep, and then I'm up, and then I'm like,
what's the reason for it?
Your body, like, falls asleep, but your eyes,
The Mexicans have a lot of ways of saying it.
Yeah,
it's
weird. Yeah.
My mom just told me not to eat a lot before I go to sleep.
Are we gonna see Jaime Munguia in the zone too? Jaime Munguia in the zone too?
He's not with Golden Boy. He's with Zanfer.
Who?
Munguia. He has a few fight deals with Munguia. Golden, but he's not with Golden Boy.
I think that December might be the last one.
So he might be in the zone?
Yeah. He might. It's possible, because what else?
Yeah. He's not on HBO anymore. Yeah, that's his
zone.
So
yeah.
Or ESPN. Do you think now their numbers is going to skyrocket through the roof? The zone.
Well, I don't know the app yet, but the way with Canelo, it's good. Now we got to talk to Eddie Hearn about a lot of the fighters. It's a good position.
Pero que no está con el Golden, so el Golden Boy.
Hizo un trato con ellos.
Pero quién es el dueño de el Eddie Hearn?
Yeah.
Es el dueño
pues
de.
Bueno, tiene inversionistas, pero tienen $1 billion. $1 billion.
Chef, you gonna cook for them right now?
Yeah. $1 billion.
So this is what it looks like.
I've never, yeah.
The zone. And
they have all kinds of shit, right?
Yeah, all kinds of.
That's good shit.
I have
and then you could connect it to your phone, to your house,
TV,
right?
Yeah.
TV, right?
Yeah. I have a thing where I could give out a month free to people, so maybe I'll just give it to you. Everybody could get a month free.